In this video, I'm going to show you 8 quick steps to boost FPS and fix FPS drops in GTA 5 on your low-end PC. Hey, what's up? I'm Victor and welcome to another video of this channel. In the first step, you're going to lower the frame scaling in your GTA 5. First, open GTA 5. Now, press escape on your keyboard, select settings and then advanced graphics. In the option frame scaling mode, select 1/2 and lastly, click on apply changes to save the change. In the second step, you're going to paste a file in the installation folder of your GTA 5 to optimize the graphics quality on your low-end PC. First, download the file command line by using the link in the description below. Now you must copy this file and find the installation folder of your GTA 5. If you play on Steam, open your library, then right-click on Grand Theft Auto 5 and then select properties. Now select local files and then click on browse, and if you play on the Epic Games Store, open the file explorer, then navigate to local disk C, program files, Epic Games and GTA 5, and lastly paste the file command line into the installation folder of your GTA 5. In the third step, you're going to disable the Fullscreen optimizations in GTA 5 to prevent performance issues in the game. First, return to the installation folder of your GTA 5, then right-click on the file GTA 5 and then select Properties. Now select the tab Compatibility and then check the option Disable Fullscreen Optimizations. And lastly, click on Apply and OK to save the change. In the fourth step, you're going to enable three options in Windows to improve performance in GTA 5. First, search for Game Mode in the Search menu and then select the corresponding option. Then, make sure this option is enabled, otherwise enable it. Now search for Power Plan in the Start menu and then select Choose a Power Plan. Then select the Power Plan High Performance. Now right click on the desktop and then select Display Settings. Scroll down until you find Graphics Settings and then select it. Now click on Browse. If you play on Steam, navigate to Local Disk C, Program Files x86, Steam, Steam Apps, Common and Grand Theft Auto 5. And if you play on the Epic Game Store, navigate to Local Disk C, Program Files, Epic Games and GTA 5. Now select the file GTA 5 and then click on Add. And lastly, click on Options, select High Performance and then click on Save. In the fifth step, you're going to set High Priority in GTA 5 to reduce FPS drops and stutter. First, download the file High Priority GTA 5 by using the link in the description below. Then unzip it to your desktop by using WinRAR. Now right-click on the file High Priority and then select Merge. Lastly, click on Yes and OK to save the change. And to undo this, just merge the file default priority. In the sixth step, you're going to disable shadows in your GTA 5. First, you open the file explorer. Now navigate to Documents, Rockstar Games and GTA 5. Right click on the file settings, select Open with Notepad and then click on OK. Now find shadow quality and then change its value to 0 and lastly save the change by clicking on File and Save. In the seventh step, I'm going to show you how to improve the performance of the Intel 8D graphics in GTA 5. First, right click on the desktop and then select Graphics Properties. Now select 3D. In Application Optimal Mode, select Enable. In General Settings, select Performance. And lastly, click on Apply to save the changes. In the eighth step, I'm going to show you some settings you can do if you have an NVIDIA graphics card to get the best performance in GTA 5. First, right click on the desktop and then select NVIDIA control panel. Then select the tab Manage 3D Settings. In Ambient Occlusion, select Performance and scroll down until you find Low Latency Mode and then select Ultra on it. In Power Management Mode, select Prefer Maximum Performance. In Texture Filtering Quality, select High Performance. In Triple Buffering, select on, and lastly click on apply to save the changes. And that was the video. If you want to boost and optimize the performance in your games, you can subscribe to this channel and then always learn new methods when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.